Hello and welcome to the Lunchtime Show for Roses 2016. I'm Harry Roberts.
And I'm Siri Hampepore. Yes, we've had a very busy morning so far. We had the latest scores for the morning badminton and futsal fixtures on roseslive.co.uk.
So just a few score updates. Lancaster are currently winning the badminton mixed tournament 6-3. Also, Lancaster and York drew in the men's futsal fixture. The scores were 3-3.
So it looks like some good news for the Lancaster supporters.
But unfortunately for Lancaster supporters, York are still in the lead in the netball tournament and in the overall points system. With an overall score of 13 wins for York and only 6 wins for Lancaster, this gives York, as of now, a very large lead. So Siri, what are you looking forward to in the Roses 2016 extravaganza?
Well, not to be biased or anything, but I'm definitely looking forward to the cheerleading competition.
The cheerleading? Why are you looking forward to that?
Well, Harry, it might be due to the fact that I am a cheerleader.
Wow, wow. So what kind of position do you do for cheerleading?
Well, I'm the flyer, which means that I'm the one that gets thrown about in the air.
Wow, that must be quite exciting. Do you enjoy it, yeah?
Yes, I definitely love it. It's a great adrenaline rush.
That's very good. Do you mind telling our viewers when they can catch the cheerleading spot?
Yes, it's going to be taking place tomorrow on Saturday in the Leica building from about 11 o'clock to, I'd say, 1 o'clock.
That's good. Yeah. I personally am looking forward to the Pokemon tournament.
Yeah.
I'm not too much into Pokemon myself, but it's when you've got all these masculine, massive sports going on, it's quite nice to just have, like, you know, a few geeky things in there just for people to do and, you know, stuff like that, which I really
enjoy.
And
it's the Pokemon card game as well. It's not actually the DS.
It's the actual legit card game.
Yeah.
I haven't played that since I was like 7. That's amazing. I really need to go watch that.
Did you used to collect the cards?
Slightly, yeah. I was always useless at the game though, so I always quit. There was always smarter kids in school who knew exactly what they were doing. And the defense cards and all that, so yeah.
Yeah.
It's a one great sports show when you talk about Pokemon.
Yeah. It is.
It's a good time. So So
hopefully we'll get some footage to show you guys that tournament.
I think this girl kind of is important because more girls and women should feel comfortable to do whatever they want to do, whether it's weightlifting or it's running or it's dancing, whether you know it's stereotypically feminine or it's incredibly masculine.
As well. the majority of the members are female. But we offer lots of opportunities
so you have a lot of men that will do femme a lot better than me and a lot of girls that do really aggressive and hard stuff. I like sport in general and keeping fit because, and it's very important to me because you can just, you know, help your body, help your mind.
So that was part of the This Roses Girl Can campaign. And it featured a lot of female sports, which is very good to see.
So yes, get involved with that campaign if you can. And as you can see, we are not in our usual LA1 TV studio. Our studio for the weekend looks out onto the Leica Pond, just in case you didn't watch the morning show. We have a new exciting feature, the duck cam.
Unfortunately, there are no ducks at the moment, but we will switch to the duck cam whenever we see one of the ducks passing by.
We have a terrible duck cam, and But what we do actually have is a video of our LA1 TV station manager, Josh, setting up said duck cam. Here is a short video of Josh in the pond. Josh Ponson, if you will.
Oh, Harry.
Okay, apparently we don't have that video.
Okay.
We don't have that video, but it was Josh in the pond. Okay, so now...
Later on in the show, we will be joined by the novice men's rowing captain, Brad Cleary, to tell us about the rowing event that occurred last weekend. We'll also be joined by James Kidd, one of the novice men's rowers.
Also, we'll be discussing some social media updates with our good friend, Thomas Owens. Cut to VT.
For now, we'll be... Yeah.
boys, they came along. It's always sad to go, but it's never that sad. Because there's only so many places to guarantee I'm getting a hug when I leave. And now on the way home, it always seems like a good idea to go paddling in the fountain. And that's because it is a good idea. And we're just like how Rousseau depicts man in the state of nature. We're undeveloped, we're ignorant, we're stupid, but we're happy.
Joined by Brad Cleary and James Kidd. Thank you for joining us.
Hi.
So we've just got a couple of questions about last week's rowing tournament. Do you feel like you improved on last year's performance?
So last year we didn't do too great. Because rowing was the founding event of Rose, it tended to be worth the most points, and last year it was worth 24 points.
Wow.
Fortunately, we didn't win any of those.
Oh.
So we came into this year with we were the underdogs, York had everything to lose, and as you may know, we were affected quite badly by the floods.
Yep.
So in total we missed 21 weeks of training.
Oh my god.
So we only had 2 weeks training before Roses, so yeah, we came in as the underdogs, and to win some points, and winning the overall men's trophy was great for us.
That is absolutely amazing, guys. Like seriously. So what did you have to do instead when the floods were about? Did you just miss training, or did you try and do other things?
We went on the water for those 21 weeks, but it was a lot of land training. We started doing the campus run every Wednesday, which
yeah.
Not many people look forward to. But otherwise, on the row machine, a couple times a week, trying to keep it consistent and keep everyone in the club, because obviously trying to keep a rowing club going without being out on the water.
Yeah.
Very difficult.
That's
yeah,
very
so
good.
You were definitely at a disadvantage from the York team, who, you know, have access to, you know, a place to practice right next to their uni.
They have a full-time coach as well. They've got like a lot more funding and stuff, so we always tend to be the underdogs.
But we have Tom, so
we have a coach this year who's like improved us massively.
Oh, that's good.
That's amazing to hear, guys, that you've come back after last year and just smashed it. Really proud of you.
You've not lost your spirit. That's the one thing Lancaster's got. Yeah, are there any events that you guys are looking forward to?
Well, obviously the main event's happened now. That was last Saturday on the river. the rugby on Sunday, the last event, that'll be good.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to the water polo.
Yeah.
And the weekend should be a good match.
Yeah, that should
Didn't
be good.
Didn't you say you're looking forward to pole fitness?
Not quite.
You're looking forward to the cheerleading. That's 11 o'clock tomorrow in Leica.
I'll be here in
Leica. Maybe we won't miss it. Don't worry.
No. Just to reiterate for the third time,
cheerleading.
So, is there anything else that you'd want to see for Roses this year?
Well, this morning we was down training in the squash courts. As we came out, we was watching badminton, so it was good to see us win some points there.
That's right.
I remember being in York last year, and it was just good to go and watch stuff that you wouldn't necessarily think, like, oh yeah, I'll go and watch that. Really just to watch as much as you can and get a glimpse of all the sports and societies.
Definitely. Are you guys going to be in Sugar tonight?
Probably.
Yes.
Yes.
We'll catch you on the TV. We'll
Sugar TV
you.
Are going to be there, so we will... Great. Make sure that we're
looking forward to seeing Mr. Jam. He's going to be at Sugar TV apparently, and it's going to be a massive thing. So
yeah, we're allowed to drink again. We had a 1 week drinking ban before, so now this week when everyone wasn't allowed to drink.
Yeah, I think quite a few of the teams I know, like the swimming water polo teams, they had a drinking ban as well.
A whole week of not drinking.
Yeah.
I know.
That is rough. That is very rough, guys.
Yeah.
Is that like a regular thing that you have to like not drink before tournaments and stuff?
Yeah.
When we have races on Saturdays, we tend to introduce it from like the Sunday before. Because we usually have Wednesday socials, but they turn into dry socials. Mm-hmm. And then we go out after the race to celebrate.
Okay, going bowling next week.
Yeah.
Sounds great, guys.
It sounds like a good reward system as well.
Yeah,
the hard work should pay off.
All right, well, thank you guys for coming down. It's been a very good to have you.
Yeah. So now we're going to look at some of the footage from the goalball tournament.
It was a tense match, and we went 3-0 up, and we thought we'd like won it at that stage, but it got more intense as the game went on. They brought on some big guys. They brought on like three like 6 foot plus guys, and they brought it back. But the Lancaster spirit really shone through there. Anything to add?
It came down to the final moments. I think we held it together.
Yeah. Just quite nerve wracking.
Very nerve wracking.
Yeah.
So we won. We won.
Yeah, we did win. We won 9-8.
8-7.
We won by one goal.
That's good.
But we're not goalball players. We were just asked to play. So we've like never played before.
So if you see the footage of us, we're not goalball players. Although if the England team is looking for selections, then we are happy to play.
Yeah, I think we should be winning there. What about the atmosphere? How did you find it? We had like a little audience chanting for you guys.
It was good.
It was good, but because you have to like listen, it was really difficult because you've got to hear the bell in the ball. So that made it a bit more difficult.
Support is good, but silent support would have been better. But like,
we still won.
But we still won. So yeah, no, loud support's fine. Yeah.
Be joined by our social media correspondent Tom Owens to discuss some of the social media updates. Thank you for joining us, Tom.
Yeah, I've enjoyed the show so far, by the way, guys. It's been great. Gone very smoothly without any technical hiccups.
Very smoothly, yes.
Very smoothly. Yeah. Our best show yet.
Speaking of things being professional, by the way, and smooth, I'm using my phone instead of an iPad to go read the social media.
That's excellent.
The first tweet that we had in actually was from Annie Potter, who said, who sounds curiously similar to the Wizard, she said, one of the biggest, most exciting weekends of the year is here. We've won one varsity this year. Can we win another? And then she hashtagged it, roses are white. So I think we know where she stands on this side of the competition. Moving on, we have another one.
Remain non-biased.
We have another one. Interestingly enough, based on Twitter, there seems to actually be more activity from the York side of things. So Lancaster do really need to pick up their game when it comes to the tweeting side.
Hashtag Lancaster, guys.
Yeah, hashtag roses are red, please. Would be really nice to read. We have another one from University Radio York that says, it's snowing for the morning of roses. Is that a sign that roses are white? Which is quite a clever one. I've got to give it
I've got to give
Radio York there.
If blood came from the sky, then we could say, yeah, roses are red, sign!
Yeah, this is a lot more grim, I suppose.
Very uncommon for blood to come
like
from the sky.
Like in Carrie,
so, like
you know.
Like to hope so, yeah, that it stays like that.
That would be...
We have another one from Rachel Castillo Lee, who says training for Roses 2016 is almost every day.
She's my cheerleading coach.
Do you do cheerleading?
I do cheerleading. So that will be in Leica at 11 o'clock.
Finish what she said. She says training for Roses 2016 almost every day on top of revision is slowly killing me. Can you relate, Siri?
I can relate to an extent because
she's not revised yet.
Like,
basically,
I'm doing the training side, but. Does the revision?
Yeah.
We are all in first year, so
exactly. Yeah, we need D minuses.
No. We can get it
solved. Fine. Not take it
it'll too seriously.
Fine.
It'll be fine. I think that's how many of you have avoided feeling like we're getting slowly killed. Is essentially just avoided revision.
Yeah, because so many people we know have been revising so hard, and I'm like, if you get a D minus, kid, you're gonna be fine.
The biomed students can revise. We're all film students, so.
Yeah, yeah. And then lastly, from who I assume is a local florist in Lancaster. She says, purple roses, anyone? And then presents a picture of her own roses. So she's on her own side.
Oh.
I don't know who purple is, apart from the Conservatory.
She's from the Iron Islands?
Okay.
Yeah. So that's all the tweets that we have for now, actually. Definitely Lancaster. Roses need to be red, and I need to see more of that. So for next show, can we please have some more tweets in from Lancaster's side of things?
All right, yes, thank you very much,
definitely.
Thomas.
Thank you for joining us this lunchtime. It is so far a great start to the Roses 2016 weekend.
And we hope to see you at 4 p.m. for the afternoon show. Make sure you head down to the Fixtures and Support Lancaster. Hashtag Roses are red.